Welcome back, children. We have discussed the first question. I have explained you first part and the second part, and I hope you have tried the rest too. Still, if you have doubt, please let me know. I'll discuss with you. So now we are going to start with the second question in this session. Now see, in the second question, they are saying that the two triangles are given, the figure is given, and this information is given that you have to prove, you have to show that these two triangles are congruent. And also they have mentioned that they are congruent, you have to show by using side congruence criteria. Is it clear? Here it means that the two triangles are congruent, you have to prove by this congruence rule. So now how will you prove that? We know that in side congruence criteria, it suggests us that if the two triangles are congruent by this rule, that means the three sides of one triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle. So here what is given? Three sides of one triangle is given. Which triangle? ART. So you have to just write down the three corresponding sides equal to this triangle, okay, on this one. Which triangle? PEN. So now we will start with the very first step, which is matching the vertices, or you can say corresponding vertices. So now how to match it? Here we will match with the triangle which are given here are congruent, ART. I have given you notes also, and I have told you before also that these are always cyclic. ART, ART and PEN. That is, A is matching with P, R is matching with E, and T is matching with N. Is it clear? So here we will use this information and write down vertex A is matching with vertex P, vertex R is matching with vertex E, and also the last vertex T is matching with N. This is one thing what we have done. Now let us move. AR, which side they are talking about? This AR. It can be the corresponding this side or this side on the another triangle. How we will know that? We'll take the help of matching vertices. AR, see, AR, with A, which side is, sorry, which point is matching P, and with R, which is the matching vertex E. So when you have AR, that means you will take it as PE. So side AR and PE, these two sides are equal. So here it will be line segment P, sorry, E. Now move RT. We have to prove that the two triangles are congruent by side congruence rule, correct? So we know that three sides of one triangle will be equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle. One side we came to know, this is the corresponding side on this triangle to this AR. Same way RT. Move, where is R? R is matching with vertex E. So E and T is matching with N. So line segment EN. Where is C? RT and what is that here written? EN. Here EN. So these two are the two corresponding sides which are equal. See, RT of one triangle is equal to the corresponding side of another triangle, which is that EN. Same way AT. Now you are left with the third side. This is AT and PN. So here you write down AT is equals to PN. Now we will also write down the reason. Okay, here you will write down AR is equal to PE. Even though it is given by side, but make it a habit of writing the reason. Why AR is equal to PE? Which congruent part of this triangle? They are the corresponding sides which are equal. You can write down corresponding sides are equal. Same way here also, RT is equals to EN. What are these two? These two are the corresponding sides. Which part we are talking about? The sides are equal. Same way here also, AT and PN. We are talking again about the corresponding side of a triangle. Because I told you, when you want to prove the congruence of any triangle, we out of 6 congruent parts, that is either 3 sides, 3 angle or combination of these two, 3 angles together we cannot take. So combination of side or angle you will take. Any 3 congruent part of one triangle should be equal to another. So that is why we just match the vertices and look for 3 parts. Here all the 3 parts are sides. So what do you get from this? We get CP, CT, that is corresponding parts of a congruent triangle. This is why triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN. By which congruence rule? By SSS congruence rule. Even though these two parts were already told to you that you have to prove they are congruent by this, but still this is the way how we solve the question for a congruency. That is, if the question was changed and just asked that prove that are two triangles ART congruent to PEN, and suppose this figure was given, this is the corresponding side equal to this one, this is equal to this one, and this is equal to this one. If it was given, in that case you have to prove it by the same method. So this is the solution for your second question. In that you have to only write down the 3 other corresponding sides which are equal. But I have explained you in detail. So you can do both the ways. But remember, for exam, it can be a changed question also. In that case, you will go by this format. Now, the B part of second question says that you have to prove the two triangles, same triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN. But this time they have changed from SSS congruence rule to SAS congruence rule. They are saying that you have to prove this time that the two triangles are congruent by using side angle, side congruence criteria. And one more information is given that angle T is equals to angle N. So how should we proceed? First thing we should know that when we say SAS, that means the angle should be included within the sides, two sides of a triangle, and it should be equal to the other two sides and the included angle of the another triangle. So in this case, first we will mark angle T is equals to angle N. How should we proceed? We will proceed by first matching the vertices or writing the corresponding vertex, okay, of each other. So here we know A is matching with P. So vertex A is matching with vertex P. Same way, vertex R is matching with vertex E, and vertex T is matching with vertex N. One information. Now, they are saying to prove it by SAS congruence rule. So here we already know this angle. Okay, only one angle is given. So which two sides we will write down? See, only information what we have is regarding the corresponding angles of the two triangles. Angle T and angle N are equal. So which two sides should we take now? We will take those two sides which include the angle. So just check, here angle is included within which side? This RT and AT. Same way here also, see, this is the two sides which include this angle. So now we have to just check AT and PN, which vertices are matching with each other. A is matching with P only, correct? That means AT is equals to PN. Same way RT, see RT. RT is matching with EN. These two sides are same, okay? So we have to take two sides of one triangle and show that the two other sides, the corresponding side of another triangle, are equal. Is it clear? Side was not given, only information was about angle. So these two sides of one triangle should be equal to another also. Only then you get the complete SAS congruence rule. You can apply it. So here we will write down that in triangle ART and PEN, which side we are talking about first? Side AT is equals to AT is matching with PN. PN, why? Because the corresponding, write down, corresponding sides are equal, or you can simply write down both the sides are equal. Then which other thing you include? What is given? Angle T. Write down that it is already given. What is this? Here the corresponding angles are equal. Okay, now which is the other side? This is the second side. RT is equals to EN. Here also the corresponding sides are equal. So SAS. Have you understood? So here we see that by CPCT. We now see here that the corresponding part of a congruent triangle. These are the corresponding part for the triangle to be congruent. That is why here you will write down. Therefore, triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN by SAS congruence criteria or congruence rule or congruence condition. Is it clear? So this completes our B part of second question. Fourth question, it is in triangle ABC, angle A is 30 degree, P is 40 and C is 110 degree. Same way in another triangle PQR, the measurement of angle P is 30, Q is 40 and measurement of angle R is 110. So here when you see the fourth question, you see the first triangle, that is triangle ABC. All the angles, measurement of triangle ABC is equal to the another triangle PQR. Yes, now they are saying, the student says that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by AAA congruence criteria. Is he justified? Why or why not? So now you tell me, the child is saying that there are two triangles given, ABC. Suppose, take example, this is ABC and the other was PQR. Now here the measurement of angle A is 30, B is 40 and here it is 110. Same way for P also it is 30, this is 40 and here it is 110. So what do you see? That angle A, measurement of angle A is equal to the corresponding part. The matching distance with A is angle P and they have same angle. Okay, here the angles are equal. Same way angle B and the matching vertices is angle Q. They both have same measurement of angles. Same way C and here angle R. See here, the angles are equal. So the child is saying that in all the three congruent parts, the angles are only equal. So therefore the two triangles are congruent. Which two triangles? Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So the question is the child saying correct? Is he correct in saying that these two triangles are congruent by AAA congruence rule? No, the answer is no, because we do not have any such congruence criteria. And why we say that? Because even if the triangle is, see here, measurement is here 30, 40 and 110. But still you can see the measurement can remain the same, but the size may vary here. Have you understood? That is why you can take two angles on one side, or two sides, one angle, or all the three sides, or by right angle triangle, that is RHS congruence criteria. But we do not have any such congruence rule, which is AAA congruence criteria. This I have explained you before also. So such tricky questions are, see, asked that all the three measurements of one angle is matching with the other angle. So that means it is congruent by angle congruence criteria. Two triangles cannot be congruent by AAA congruence criteria. because even though the measurement will be same, but you can see the measurement of the size may vary. So please, now you complete the second question's C part, and the fourth question I'll explain you. Frame it in your own words. God bless you.